Welcome to the podcast Friday Feels, brought to you by the Office of Counseling and Wellness at Berklee College. I'm your host and personal counselor, Sarah Nickerson. Join our journey with Berklee students as they navigate the challenges of the current pandemic with strength, creativity, and wisdom. New episodes released every Friday. Thanks for listening. Okay, so Tiffany, welcome to Friday Feels. We're so happy to have you on here today. How are you feeling?
I'm feeling good. Thank you for having me.
Good. So usually we just start by having the student tell us a little bit about themselves. So if you want to share what campus you're at, what you're studying, your hobbies, anything you want to share, I'd love to hear.
Okay, here we go. What about me? Okay, so hi, my name is Tiffany Gary. I go to Berklee College. I'm studying to be in graphic design. That's my bachelor's.
Oh, nice.
I'm trying to get my major in illustration. I'm hoping to go to SVA after everything's over.
Very cool.
I love art. I want to be a part of as much art projects as I can be a part of, whether it's freelance or working with a really good company. Wow. And just taking everything step by step, you know?
Yeah. What kind of art do you illustrate, or what do you enjoy illustrating?
I meant, honestly, like, I like cartoons. Anime is my favorite. So
yeah,
so I like doing that. But I've noticed that I like more crafty things. So I like embroidery. Yeah. I like doing resin charms. I like making cards, stuff like that. I found that I enjoy. A lot
That's
of people
amazing.
Say it's an old lady hobby, but I
no.
think it's quite peaceful in me. So that's why I like doing.
Yeah. What was the one thing you said you like doing? Resin charms? Is that
yeah,
said?
Resin charms. Yeah.
What is that?
It's like, so basically it's like a chemical that it's like a hardener and, I forgot what the other one is, but it's like two chemicals you put together and it like crystallizes and makes like a hard piece. So it's like charms essentially.
Whoa, that's so cool. I would love to see pictures if you want to send me any of these crafts. Love crafting. So send me pictures.
I have an Instagram, so.
Perfect. That's awesome. So do you make this stuff for yourself? Do you give it away? What do you do?
I like to call it passion projects. I haven't like really gotten to the point where I feel comfortable selling any of my stuff because I have this thing where if it's not perfect, I don't want to sell it. You know, I want what I give out to be like the utmost best. So right now it's just passion projects. I hope to, you know, get an Etsy one day and try to sell my stuff. But right now I'm just enjoying everything.
Yeah, doing it for you as a way to kind of de-stress and creatively express yourself. That's really cool.
Yeah.
Have you always been interested in art, or is this like a more recent?
Oh, always. Always. Ever since I saw like, I've always been artsy as a kid, but I would say anime really got me into like wanting to just go the whole art route and just stick with it. My first anime was Inuyasha. I remember I was like not even 10 years old yet, and we were going through the channels, me and my sister, late at night, and then we finally passed the channel and Inuyasha was playing, and I could not watch it, you know. She went and she changed it and I was like, wait, go back. And after that I was hooked. So
what drew you into it, do you think? Like, what do you think captivated you so much?
I'm not sure. I guess it was because it wasn't like most cartoons, you know.
Yeah.
It was a little different from like the American cartoon. And I watched Sailor Moon when I was younger. Didn't really do anything for me, but for some reason Inuyasha just felt so different. It like drew me in like way more than anything. So
wow, that's so cool. And in the pandemic, do you find that like doing art and more crafty things has increased for you, or was it sort of all you've always kind of done this much?
Well, I meant during the pandemic, it was definitely a stressful time for me. I think it's hard being inside all the time, especially during the lockdown. At first it was like nice and cool, but then I realized that like as artsy as I wanted to be, I also wanted to be outside, you know, and I couldn't. So it got to a point where it just got kind of dark for me, and it became like I want to do stuff, but my motivation, my inspiration, all that kind of dwindled, disappeared. It became more of like, what am I doing right now? All this time is passing and I'm not like getting anything done, regardless of all the stuff I wanted to do.
Yeah, I think that's been a real struggle for most people in the pandemic, including myself. It's like you look at the clock and you're like, I know I've been doing things, but I don't know exactly what I've been doing. And I feel like I've accomplished nothing.
Exactly. And I tried, like, I tried to get into the art mood, doing art challenges, trying every day to like do something to put me in the art, you know, environment, you know, feel that way. But I couldn't, like, I felt so down for some reason. Yeah. And the thing about pandemic is like, I feel like a lot of people didn't know why they felt down, you know, like I didn't know why. I just felt like upset for no reason, you know, no reason.
Oh yeah. No, that's such a good point. I think like sometimes it's hard, especially if nothing specific is happening in your life. It's like you can get really discouraged just feeling like, you know, I'm down for no reason, or maybe I don't have it as bad as other people. But I always tell, you know, friends and myself and students, like there's a collective energy in the air that I think that we feel. And there's like a lot of grief and trauma and pain and loss and all these things that are happening all around us. And so I think it's a really normal and natural response to start to embody some of those feelings and experience them within. And it sounds like you're really self-aware. So you were able to kind of notice that.
Yeah, I'm going to say like, I definitely got there, you know, I did start counseling because I had, you know, how do I say it? Like when you start to feel that way because of the pandemic, it's so quick to blame it on other things other than being like, huh, I think something's wrong internally compared to like, like my life's fine. It's okay. But like what's going on inside that's making me feel like there is like nothing that's okay. You know, I found myself like upset with little things, you know, and then I realized, you know, I've been stuck in a house for this long, you know, like I haven't been going outside because I've been too afraid to. And then when I finally started to go outside, you know, I felt like I, you know, lost the part of me. I did, you know, get out of a relationship too because of the pandemic.
That's hard.
I felt, I'm not alone. I've heard that I'm not alone. You know, many people have been going through what I've been going through, you know, whether it's, you know, where your relationships ended or, you know, you've been just feeling kind of wound up over things. You felt like you lost yourself in a way. And I'm just trying to be self-aware and kind of get back to how I was, get back to who I want to be, you know, in a sense, you know, be better than I was before, because, you know, I got to this part and I want to be better for me.
Yeah. Oh, there's so many things. Is there something particular about counseling that kind of helped you to get to a better space?
Just having someone to talk to, you know, I do have like, I would say two people I can talk to support wise in my life, but like, I want an outside non-biased opinion.
Yeah.
Completely. Like they don't know my situation, you know, they don't really know me, but like they can hear me out and give me such like an outside perspective.
Yeah.
Just so I know, you know, and it's just like, I like being heard too. Cause like sometimes you can feel when someone's not really listening to you, you know, like, cause they've heard you so much. So I did seek out counseling just to feel a little more grounded, to know like my feelings are valid in a way because this other person is telling me exactly how I feel about it is either the right way or the wrong way. But I know that they understand, like I'm feeling this way, like, oh, you're feeling this way. I understand, compared to someone being like, you know, like, oh man, that sucks. You know, like you want somebody to understand that like, oh, you can feel this way and it's completely fine.
Oh yeah. Yeah. And I think there's something that's so special about somebody just listening with their heart and not their head. So sometimes friends with all their good intentions will be like, well, have you tried this? Or like, don't be sad, or, you know, you should think about it this way. But there's such a difference in the felt experience of someone being like, wow, oh man, I'm like feeling this with you, or at least I'm coming into this space with you, instead of sort of someone who's on the outside just being like, well, good luck with that.
Yeah. And I meant my support group isn't like that. Like, but I have like two different ones. I have one that is like tough, you know, that's like, tell it how it is, you know? And then I have another one that's like, well, however you feel. And I just want like the outside. I want someone who doesn't doesn't want to tell me tough, doesn't want to tell me sweet, just wants to tell me, you know, in general. You know what I mean? I
don't. Yeah. No. That makes sense for sure. Like someone who is able to remain objective and kind of reflect back to you and help you to make the right decision for yourself.
Yeah.
And to listen to your own intuition.
And I'm definitely new at it all. So like, I'll still talk to my counselor and apologize at the end and be like, thank you for listening to me. But I think I feel better when I talk about everything because I realize that like, it's all bottled up. Like I want to talk to people about it, but there's a part of me that feels like, yeah, I've said it before, you know, but I just haven't talked about it to the point where it's just like, either I get emotional or I get lost in the end, you know, like after a while you're like, so you're talking about all the things that like are bottled up. And then in the end you're like, huh, I'm kind of lost. What was I talking about? You know?
Yeah, for sure. That's good though that you have that outlet and you've been able to find a space where you feel like you can talk about what's going on with you. Are there other self-care things that have been helpful for you during this time?
I want to meditate. That's my next goal. I haven't, sister. Every time I go to it, I end up thinking like, huh, let me check my bills. I get so sidetracked, but I try my best I watch like so many videos about, you know, like being grounded, being present. And a lot of the times it's all about like acknowledging that you're thinking a negative way. And instead of like being like, oh God, no, let me not think like that. You know, be like, I'm thinking like this because, and then saying it out loud. So you hear like, this is what it really is. This is what really has you thinking like this. And then letting it go. You know, I'll think about something that's like not even true, you know, and then I'll be like, why am I thinking like this? Because I'm afraid of this, this, and that. And then after that, I let it go. I've said it. I already know I'm afraid. There's no need for me to think about it because I've already said what I'm afraid of, you know?
Wow. Yeah. I think like there's so much value to what you're saying in the sense that it's like you're able to observe yourself, whereas before maybe you would have participated in those thoughts and feelings without kind of getting that distance. Yeah. But now you're able to look at it and be like, interesting. That's an interesting thought.
It's crazy because now that I do it, I notice I do it a lot, you know? So like I'm constantly trying. I mean, that's the type of person like that has always been my problem. Like I'm not present. I'm always like either in my past or in my future. And I try to think like, well, I can't get to either place. I can't go back to the past. I can't get to the future, you know? So I try to keep myself like, okay, you're worrying about this or okay, you're thinking about this. Why, you know, what's bringing you there and then come back, you know, like, cause it's, you can only do so much with what you got. So like come back and I try and I notice I go pretty far, but I always try to bring myself back.
Yeah. Sometimes I think about it as if like if there was a string tied around our waist that was always connected to the present moment. And so if we can kind of find that string and follow it back, then like you said, you know, we can't travel to the past. We can't travel to the future. All we really have is the present moment. And there's so much to be found in the present moment. I know for myself, like one of the things that I've been thinking about and learning about is the idea of belonging.
Yeah. Oh my goodness.
Yeah. We're always like yearning for belonging in some sort, like in a partner or maybe a family or like in the pandemic when we don't have community. And I feel like being in the present has been reminding me that there are these little pockets of belonging, like whether it's I'm in line at the grocery store and the woman in front of me starts talking about like the sausages she's buying, and for that like brief, you know, 3-minute conversation we belong to each other, or you know, some of the kids in my neighborhood went sledding when the snow was here and I like went sledding with them and I was like, for a few moments, like I belonged in this little group of, you know, joyful kiddos who were sledding. And all of that can be found, but it can only be found in the present moment. It's just sort of teaching ourselves to turn our attention to what's in front of us.
That's cool. I've never like thought in that mindset. I feel like I should. To me, it was always, like little signs that showed me like, hey, like, you know, not that you're being watched, but like, hey, appreciate you, you know, like, hey, I see you, or like, what was it? Something silly. I saw this little Instagram thing. And it was just like, you know, these people make these videos that are very like encouraging of, you know, people that are suffering, you know? So
yeah, yeah.
I saw this video of, it had like a little quote in it. It's like, hey, this is from your future self, just letting you know you made it and everything's okay. You know, yeah. like whatever you're yeah. going through, you're going to get there. And it's just, you know, a lot of people would think, oh, someone made that, but it's all about changing your mindset, changing that person's mindset when they read it, of acknowledging like whatever they're going through, we see that and you can be here, but you just got to know that all this right now is gonna be this, and you just have to get past it to get here. And that's how I take it. So like when I see little things like that, I it means so much to me, because I feel like you know, there is some type of, you know, force telling me that, hey, everything's gonna be okay. Like nothing feels good right now, but it will get better, you know? So
and those moments are like all we really have, especially in a
all
pandemic,
we have of course
so
of
many course. Things are dark and difficult, and so just being able to soak up those moments of like, wow, like I love what you said, like, oh, I feel seen, like
yeah,
I matter, like my space in the universe is important. And but and sometimes we can just be so focused on what we don't have or what we want that we forget that there's a wealth.
I am all about that's my negative side. Like I'm always just like I've told my counselor, like, I feel like I could be a very envious person sometimes, but not in a in a negative way. Like, oh, I don't want a person to have what they have, but it's like, I want it too. You know, why have I not gotten it? And it's just like, okay, but what do you have?
Yeah.
You know, and it's like, it's, you could have that, but you never worked for it before. So how could you have it if you haven't pushed towards it? You know, and I think a lot of people have to understand that when it comes to, I mean, even myself, when it comes to envious, when you're being envious of somebody else, it's all about like, what is it that they have that you know that you have in yourself that you have not, you know, obtained. Right. You know, for me, it's like, I used to be, I'm a very shy person, but I feel like I've gotten more shy because of the pandemic. You know, I haven't talked in so long. Yeah. So for me, it's like, there was a girl in my class and she was so talkative, and I felt a little like, oh my God, she's talking so much. And I was just like, where is this coming from? Where is this like this like feeling coming from of like, oh, she's talking so much? And when I really questioned it, it was like, I envy the fact that she can be so, you know, so open, so expressive when I'm here being so, you know, closed off. So, you know, to myself, when I know I could be at that way, I could be so open, you know? So it's all about, you know, taking a step back and like really looking at yourself as if you're looking at a picture frame and being like, what's that about, you know?
So yeah, and just noticing the things within you. And yeah, I love that. And there's like so many ways to move in that direction. Like I think sometimes we'll get fixated on one path, like this is the only way that I can do this, and being open to like lots of different possibilities. I know I had a friend who, she's in her probably like mid 30s, and she recently was divorced, and she was like really having a hard time with, you know, she really wants kids. And that feels kind of like far away for her. But she said, you know what? There are many ways to be a mother. And she's, you know, practicing in her life, like different ways of being a mother that might not necessarily be natural childbirth, but she was like, you know, I can volunteer and work with kids, or I can tend to my plants.
I thought that too.
Yeah. Or I can be like nurturing to my friends. And so she was like, it's, you know, much better for me to focus on these ways in which I can, you know, manifest this part of me that I really want, while, you know, not giving up on the idea of ever having my own kids, but including it, you know, even here, even now. So
for me, it's like we give ourselves, like, I mean, we do. It's what has been shown to us. There's a timeline we set for ourselves. Oh, you know, we set like, at this time I want this, at this time I want this, and at this time I should have this. When in reality, like the world, you know, the world waits for no one. You know, the world is changing, and then, you know, soon we realize that 21 is the new 30. You know what I mean? We realize that being in our 40s is still the same as being in our 30s, you know, or 21 even. and like the it's all about, you know, what makes you happy. And it's so easy to be like, okay, well, this would make me happy if I did this when I was this age, but you should be happy with it now because you have, you got it now. You know what I mean? Like you got it.
Oh, I love that. Well, my last question for you will be, if you had to give any advice or encouragement to other Berkeley students, what would it be?
Okay. I'm going to say this because I notice on all my classes, but nobody does it. Tell the teacher when you're confused, when you don't get something. Like, it's, you are in the school to learn, and in no way should a should you feel like the teacher has no right to help you when you're confused. It's okay to say, I don't get it. It's okay to say, I'm sorry, can you explain that a different way? Like, it's all about, you're in school to get the help you need to learn something. And I've seen so many kids, like even myself, I've been afraid to open my mouth and say, wait, I don't get that. But you know, there are times when you have to realize, hey, I need help, because you're going to sit in the class and not get it anyway. So you might as well say, hey, I don't get it. Can you explain it? Just ask for help. It doesn't hurt. It really doesn't.
Oh, I love that.
It's ask for help in everything. Yeah, exactly. In everything. Ask for help in everything. If you're struggling, even if you're like hot, like independent, I asked for no help, but you're really struggling, take that time to be like, all right, I'm weak right now. I need help. And you won't even be weak. If anything, it makes you stronger because you can take the time to be like, I need help, regardless of anything. I need help. So get help. Seek help. If you need it, go get it.
That's right. Yeah. And there's so much like, you know, resources available to us that sometimes we just don't take advantage of, like you said, because we're afraid or because we feel like we don't deserve it. And especially in New York City, like there's so many free resources, groups, clubs, organizations, you know, food pantries. Like there's like a million different things that you can really have access to, but we just have to be able to kind of get outside of ourselves a little
bit. It's there for you. There's help everywhere. You look up any type of group, there's a help group for it. Anything. Go get the help you need. You know you need it. Go get it.
Go get it. Well, Tiffany, it was so great to have you on here today. You're such a wise, vibrant, effervescent human being. And I'm excited for you to see where your future ends up with your illustrating and
Thank you.
And I'd love to see your crafts as well. So
thank you.
I wish you the best of luck.
Thank you so much for everything. I wish you the same.
All right, Tiffany, have a great rest of your day.
You too. Bye. Bye.
That's all for now. Join us next week for another episode of Friday Feels. Enjoy your weekend and stay safe. Be well.